Previously on Puggsy. Puggsy scaled to the top of Fireheart Mountain, blew open the top of the volcano, and engaged in a death-defying battle with the deadly dragon, Halitosis. Puggsy emerged victorious and is ready to continue plumbing the depths of Dark Skull Castle. Duke of the Bump, move the mouse cursor away from the window. Okay. I remember what this level was all about. So, this flashlight reveals secrets. Secret letters. A ghost. A ghost holding an E. Puggsy wields the lightning gun. Puggsy defeats the ghosts. Letters are falling everywhere. It's utter madness. Oh. My gun is broken. Well, how am I supposed to get those letters now? Can I just chuck other letters at them? Chuck? Ow. Well, I can lose my speed shoes. That's one strategy. No, that does not work. Oh. Okay. Yeah, for some reason, I thought that lightning gun would have unlimited shots. So I need to figure out which letters I need, and then only defeat the ghosts carrying those letters. Let's reshod myself. Now see, with the duct tape mod, you can just stick the flashlight to the gun, so you don't have to turn the flashlight on, or you don't have to switch to the flashlight every time you need to see. That's a joke. Although, it would be neat if you could stack the flashlight on top of the gun, and then the flashlight would turn in the appropriate direction. And stick to the gun. But alas, it doesn't. Alright, so I need an M. I need an R. Mister. Okay, so I can, in fact, get back up here. MRC. Mr. C. Are those the only ones? Ow. So do I just like... No! Ow! Ah! I'm scared. I'm scared of ghosts, y'all. You can't jump on a ghost's head. It's a terrifying apparition. Okay. Puggsy is now cool enough to not be scared of ghosts. Alright, so MRC. Now the question is, would they put other letters that aren't at arm height that you have to jump to see? I don't think they would do that. But I don't know. I did not design this game. But as a game designer, I would not put letters above arm height. That would be a little bit too too big of an ask. So let's try it with just the MRC. I still need to figure out what I do with the MRC. I think I just slot them into the appropriate places. Wonder if MRC is the initials of one of the developers. That seems likely. And to me, that's another reason why there's probably only three. If you were spelling out a word, there might be more than three, but it seems like it's initials, so... Alright, so do I just bring the R there and place it in that slot? Ah! Ghosts are spooky. Okay. Alright, so the C goes down here, and the M goes up at the top. Do I need to be shining the flashlight on the M? I don't think so. I think I just... yeah. Heck yeah. And then C is down here? Awesome. Another puzzle solved. That score goes up awfully high. It goes up to a million minus one, and I only have 69,000 points. And I'm more than halfway done with the game, which makes me think that my performance is not so great. But I have some awesome shoes, so who's to say whether I'm good or bad? Ah, I'm being cooked. Aw, look at the pumpkins. They're kinda cute. What's up, frog? Alright. Oh no! Oh, I'm going to have to do something unspeakable to that frog, right? Because there's a cauldron. And like the old witch's incantation, like Eye of Newt, Tongue of Frog, something like that. Was that from... The Tempest? I don't know. I'm not super up on my Shakespeare. I think that's The Tempest. I mean, it was okay, but it's no Tempest 2000. That game is art. I've been playing some of that recently because within the last year or so, there's been a huge advancement in Atari Jaguar emulation, and Tempest 2000 is the one Atari Jaguar game you would want to play, like unironically, and. It's pretty fun. I hit a difficulty plateau around level 25. There are 100 levels in the game, and I'm not the world's best like arcade game player. I do enjoy it, but I'm not going to practice enough to get good enough at Tempest 2000 to actually get to level 100. I would do a let's play of that game, but it's literally just moving a ship around the perimeter of a tube and shooting aliens and stuff, which I don't think would be super interesting to watch. Oh, I see. So I have to defeat that bat with this wooden beam, I think. But I don't know if I want to throw my knife in there, because I think I'm going to need the knife. And I don't know if it'll let me have the knife back. I figure it will, but better safe than sorry. Alright. Nope. Also, a green sunglasses case. How odd. Okay. I could have used the knife. Alright. Wing of Bat. He gave me the good puzzle sound. Hopefully I don't need that bread or that apple. The only obvious ingredients I'm seeing are Wing of Bat and Tongue of Frog. It sucks that I have to do this. Aw, look at how sad it is. I'm sorry. Oh wait, that's the leg of the frog. You can see its left leg is missing now. Oh, that's not very nice. Oh god. Okay. So I lost the knife. So I need to go back for some sort of other object. Which I think the only thing that's left is the sunglasses case. The case of the green sunglasses. Starring Puggsy. Alright, so the egg I'm... Oh, I see. So I can trap this thing. I figure it's supposed to be a zombie raccoon. But now... Alright, so I need to take this egg. Okay, so that raccoon doesn't need to be trapped now because I have no reason to go back in there. So I needed another object to get back up to that switch. Alright, egg of raccoon. And it gives me a potion. Potion seller. Sell me your strongest potion. So, is this going to make me float? And if so, should I be at the bottom of this pit, or should I be standing on that platform? Like, closer to the top. This music's pretty good. Nice, decent loop. Oh. Oh gosh. Oh, Puggsy's a super jumper now. Oh, that is so cool. I forgot about this. I wonder if the potion wears off. If I have to, like, quickly get to the exit. Or if I can go back and explore. Not that I think that there is much else to explore here. I'm sorry, frog. Oh, it's just fun to zoom around the level like this. Whee! Oh, that is awesome. I wish I could take this potion into other levels with me, but... That would probably break the game in several ways. Look at me, creepy gargoyles. I'm flying. Sort of. The gargoyles are unfazed. Alright, well, that's enough horsing around. Another guardian. Get ready. I do not remember the boss of this area. Okay. So it's a bat with a sword. Ow. Oh, I can't three buttons my way out of a boss fight. I guess if I did, I would have to do that level over again. Oh, do I jump on the sword? I wanted to go back for speed shoes. Okay. So I jumped on the bat that time and nothing happened. So I need to jump on the sword, which sounds counterintuitive. But I think this will be doable. Ah, oh, I thought I was a goner. Okay. Situation under control. All right. Well, hopefully that bat was brutally oppressing the frog that lived in that castle, so I may have needed the frog's leg, but hopefully the frog can find some kind of freedom now. That's going to be my headcanon for mutilating that frog. It sucks that I had to do that. Meanwhile, alright, Puggsy ship is in some sort of ancient Roman plaza. The critters are doing something. They have some sort of design on that ship. All right, let's go back for some shoes. Aztec Temple. I mean, not really, because the Aztecs were like an actual civilization. But you know, Aztec-ish. Okay. Aztec-esque. Oh, this is good music. Alright, the wind up there is fierce, so is his head heavy enough to weigh me down and walk past the wind? I think so. I think that's the solution. Ah! Game just turned into Decap Attack. Carrying around a head that I can throw. I don't think I should throw it. Crud. Nope. Maybe I can throw it at this fellow. Or just hop on him. Okay. So I don't know what I need this dynamite for, but I'm sure it's going to be something. So. Chuck the dynamite in a direction and hope it all works out. Ah, I see. Dynamite. That's Pugsy's new catchphrase. Dynamite. Pugsy's a man of a few vices, but he does enjoy his dynamite from time to time. Jewels. Huh. Is this thing just gonna open on me? Maybe I should throw a jewel up there. Ah. I see. Well, dang. Now I wish I walked to the left to see what was over there. 900 points. I'm sorry to keep going back for shoes, but it just makes the game so much more pleasant to play. That's the wrong level again. At least I don't have to finish the level. Alright, let's see if I can do this a little bit more smartly this time. Alright. I was just seeing if there were any other threats ahead that I needed to destroy with my gun. Yeah, I'm not sure how to get past the other bird. Like, maybe I can make it to the bird without the head. But I just need the head to get past that point. I don't know. I don't know if I can make this jump with the wind the way it is. And I can't, like, throw the gun because it'll just get blown back to the left. Yeah, I'm not sure. Like, maybe I can throw the head at the bird, but I don't know if the head will be blown back so I can grab it again, you know? Let's try. Okay, it does. Yeah, I thought the head might be too heavy. Might be too heavy for me to throw it at all. That's unfortunate. Yeah, I'm not sure what the intended solution is here. Maybe I can jump on it. I tried going under it last time, and that didn't work out super well. Oh, okay, so it does a pattern. It flies low, and then it flies high. So I just need to wait for it to fly high. I think that was my... Well, whatever. Sigh. I mean, it's not like shoes are hard to come by, but... You know. The principle of the thing, etc. Oh, maybe I was supposed to walk with the head balanced on top of the gun. Huh. I don't know if that would have worked. Alright. Let's see if there is anything to the left. This might just be a waste of time. Oh, there's another exit. Nice. I thought there might be. I strongly suspected. Aztec Games. Oh yeah. This is weird. So, if I bounce that dis thing into the question mark... So this might be a way to like farm extra lives. Like, I remember there being something good about this. I mean, other than it just being a fun, weird minigame. Yeah, so you can do this over and over again. To build up your extra life counter. Okay. Which is probably one of the reasons I wasn't concerned about getting extra lives, because I figured that there would be something like this at some point. I'm not gonna keep doing this. If I do need to farm extra lives for whatever reason, I can do it off camera. But that's good to have open. And I don't need to do that level again because I already unlocked the other exit. Alright, I figure that'll about do it for this episode. We have another level of the Aztec Temple, and then I think I move on to the last area of the game. Like, I think I'm almost done. I might finish this game this week, which is exciting. When I was a kid, this felt like the longest game I ever played, with like a huge sprawling world, because, you know, games were rarely this big, and I didn't have a SNES at the time, so I hadn't played Super Mario World. But yeah, coming back to it, it's not that long. There weren't a lot of, like, 40-hour games back in the day to compare it to. But yeah, thanks for watching. I'm excited to keep playing and to finish this up. Goodbye.